So I'm just going to say something about duration of load, which is a property of wood, which is a viscoelastic material, viscoelastic. And what happens is that you can have a piece of wood and apply a load to that piece of wood. And if the load isn't applied for very long, the wood will deform, and then once you remove the load, it will return back to its original shape, and that behavior is classic elastic behavior. But if you apply a load for a very long time, so I'm now applying the load for maybe a couple of months, and then I release the load, the wood undergoes some sort of permanent deformation. And that is referred to as creep. The problem is that it depends how long you apply the load for. You can actually have a situation where you get a permanent deformation, but it slowly returns to its original shape. It really depends how long you've applied the load for. So this is quite complicated behavior. And it takes quite complicated rheological models to explain that behavior. I'm not going to go into that depth of explanation. It's just something to be aware of. Durational load is very important. And one of the issues of durational load is that if you have a piece of wood and you load it constantly for a very long period of time, you can actually change its behavior. If you load it for several years, let's say, at 20% of its failure load, you can then test it and find that its failure is now lower than it was if you tested a fresh piece. So this durational load can affect the mechanical properties of the wood. And that has to be taken account of in the design rules when you design structures. So there's always a safety factor put in which will take care of the fact that this durational load issue is present in wood. It's one of the complications of using wood that's well understood. And as I say, there are safety factors built in to account for this. But if we think about what's happening at a molecular level, if we model the surface of the microfibril, so those are the cellulose chains, and we have the hemicellulose here, and if remembering back to a previous lecture, I probably haven't left enough room, if we have the hydroxyl groups, which are bonding the cellulose to the hemicellulose, like this. If water comes along, it can put itself between these two hydrogen bonding regions. So it acts like a lubricant, or it can act, yeah, like a lubricant, like ball bearings, if you like. So it will actually allow, if we have the surface of the microfibril and the surface of the hemicellulose, the rigid linear part of the hemicellulose, we've got this kind of lubricant zone here where the water molecules sit, and they allow that these hydrogen bonds to break and then reform. So we get this what's called a stick slip mechanism. So if we're applying a load for a long period of time, we will get permanent movement of these regions, and that explains the creep. So you don't get it with dry wood. You need water to be present.